Okay, so we'll basically continue with elementary programming, and we start today basically this chapter on simple programming in Java. And first thing that I want to tell you about are variables. So in a program, variables store data. They are basically an alias for a location of in memory that may store data, and you can basically assign a new data to that location or read the value from that location. There are two types of variables in Java and most modern programming languages like C#. Basically, there are primitive type variables where the value itself is stored in that location that basically contains that was created for that variable. Like for instance, integer I is equal with 1, character letter is equal with A. And there are object or reference types, where the variable itself actually is a reference to another place which contains actually multiple values, multiple pieces of the data. A string is actually such a reference variable in Java. So when you have something of this kind, string text is equal with a string that contains A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Basically, string text is a reference to an object of the type string that contains those letters. Okay, so let me actually try to draw for you what I mean by this two different kind of variables in Java. Okay, so first I said that there are primitive variables. So when you define something of this kind, integer I is equal with 3. The meaning is really that there is a location of the type integer that has the alias I. So basically I is the name of that location, and that location gets the value 3. That's what it is, okay? So basically the variable itself will be assigned that value. The variable itself is a location that has that value. Now, how is this different from string text is equal with AB? Okay. The difference is as follows. Text is actually not, does not contain AB. Text contains an address. So it's basically some binary address to some other place. Usually in this case, it's actually in the global segment of memory because this is an internal string. And this place is in fact an object of the type string. That contains, so this is string, and this string contains actually the string AB. It may contain many other things. It may contain, for instance, different pieces. It may contain the length, or, but in our case, it only contains that this contains A and it contains B in a sequence. So the difference is that this is what is called a primitive type, basically meaning that it's a primitive type variable. The value itself is stored in that variable. And this is a reference type. Basically, the variable itself doesn't contain the value. It just contains a reference or a pointer or an address of where the value is actually stored in memory, okay? That's the difference. Basically, in one case is the value itself. There are only 8 primitive types in Java. And the other one is a reference or an address of where the object is stored. So let me actually tell you what are the 8 different primitive types. Primitive types in Java are, first of all, we have the Boolean type. Boolean are basically variables that either contain true or false. Then there is the car type. So for instance, a character is A. It only contains one single Unicode for a single character. Then there are the integer types. So the smallest one is byte. Byte B, let's say, is equal with 127. It basically a byte, it's anything that can be stored in 8 bits. And it's basically maximum value is 255 when all the bits are one, or zero when all the bits are zero. Then we have short, which are actually 2 bytes. So it can store values that can be stored on 16 bits in length. So maybe storing something like 300, that cannot be stored in a byte because it's not big enough to store 300, that number in binary. Then int. So int is 4 bytes. It can store maybe some this value. And then there is long. Long is 8 bytes. So it can store quite big values like billions. Okay. And then there are 2 real number types. So there is float. So for instance, 1.2 as a float number. And there is double. So 1.234. You can also use the scientific notation E-2. It basically means that you multiply that number with the base to the power minus 2. So in fact, this is 0.012345. Okay. These are all the primitive types in Java. 8, Boolean, char, then 4 integer types and 2 real types. Everything else in Java is a reference type. Any questions? 1.2f, excellent question. So when you only put 1.2 as a constant, Java considers it to be double. And double is bigger than float. You can't assign a double to a float variable. So if you want that number to be interpreted as a float number that can be stored, that is stored on 4 bytes instead of 8 bytes, you have to put that this is a float number. So I will just add comments after each one of these. This is basically can be represented as a single bit. You have it 0 or 1, true, false or true. Char, Java uses Unicode encoding called UTF-16, UTF-16, meaning that by default you are using 2 bytes to represent a Unicode. However, if it's a variable length encoding of Unicode, so variable length, I will not get into such detail. Basically, it says that for most characters, you will only need 2 bytes, but sometimes if you need longer than 2 bytes Unicodes, you have the last bit can be used as a continuation bit and use another byte for it. Then you have byte, which obviously is just represented on 1 byte. Or 8 bits. Then you have short, which is 2 bytes in length, in size. Then you have int, which is 4 bytes, long, which is 8 bytes, float, which is also representing a real number on 4 bytes, and double, which represents a real number on 8 bytes. Okay. And I will get into details next class, because we basically kind of reached the end of the class. So let's take some questions. If the variable contains the address of the value, would it return false if you try to check if the strings are the same? A, B, and text equal with A, B. So it depends. This is a very good question. And I think you may be ready to for getting the answer. So if you do something like this, string text is equal with AB, and then you want to see Boolean B is equal if text is the same with AB. So in this case, the result is true. And the reason why is that these are both interpreted by Java compiler as constants. Basically, it only creates one single, it's called an interned string. It only creates one instance, and then when you do this comparison, it says, yes, it's the reference of both objects is the same. However, if you do this, this is a new string that contains a B. Now, the answer here is false. Because although these contain the same letters, the references are different. This is a new string that contains a b, and this is the constant string that contains a b. So that's why the answer is a little bit tricky to that question, Jandy. Basically, and I will cover this. There is a difference in Java between strings created with a new string or strings created with intern strings, those strings that appear in the code as just a constant. It's a compiler error. So one other question from Caleb is, if you have float f is equal with 1.2, this will be a syntax error detected by the compiler. Okay, good. That's all for today. If there are no more questions, I will stop the recording.